Good morning, students. Welcome to the computer class of 4th standard. Today we will continue with the chapter 4, formatting a document. So open page number 36. Previously we have learnt about introduction to formatting, changing the font type, applying bold, italic and underline effects, changing text alignment, changing text color, changing text case, setting line spacing and setting paragraph spacing. And today we will learn about creating bulleted or numbered list. And the main objective of the day is, what is the meaning of bullets, how they enhance the appearance of our document, and what are the steps to apply these bullets. So open page number 39. Before starting our topic, we will discuss the terms. So our first term is bullet, a small graphic symbol that sets off an item in a list. Graphic means a symbol which is having images. Now I will show you some examples of the bullets. These are the bullets which are highlighted by a rectangle. You can see these examples. So bullets makes the appearance of a document more attractive and beautiful. Now the second term is tab stop, used to describe the location at which the cursor stops. So now open page number 39. And our first topic is creating bulleted or numbered list. We can format list in a document by using bullets and numbers. Students, previously we have learnt different formatting commands like bold, italic, underline, font, font size, font color. Similarly, bullets and numbers are used to format our document. So it is a small graphic symbol that sets off an item in a list. Now, what are the steps to apply these bullets to our text? First step is select the text. Second is click on the bullets button, which is present in paragraph group. Third is select the bullet choice. So let's do its practical by opening MS Word window. Our Word window is opened on the screen, and students, you can see that by default Home tab is open, and in the paragraph group of Home tab we are having the bullets ID. This first ID is known as bullets and second is known as numbering bullets. So first of all, we will apply a bullet to our main heading, and to apply the bullet, the steps are select the text, click on bullets button and click on any style. So you can see that we have applied a bullet to our main heading. Similarly, suppose you want to apply numbering bullets to the text, first of all select the text, second is click on numbering bullet, and third is click on any style. You can observe the changes also. So this is the way to apply numbering bullets to our text. Similarly, if you want to change these numbering bullets to simple bullets, first of all select the text, second is click on bullets button, and third is click on any style. So this is the way to convert numbering bullets into simple bullets and vice versa. Now the shortcut key to insert blank lines in a bulleted or numbered list is Shift plus Enter key. So let's do its practical. Now suppose you want to insert a blank line in between the bulleted or numbered list, then you have to press the shortcut key Shift plus Enter key from the keyboard. You can see that a blank line is inserted in between the bullets. Now on page number 41, our next topic is in Let's Know More. Tab stops are used to describe the location at which the cursor stops after the tab key has been pressed. Tab stops are commonly used to enable users to align text easily by pressing the tab key. So this feature of MS Word is used to describe the location at which your cursor will stop, and the by default tab stops are set at every 0.5 inch. But we can also set the tab stops by using ruler. So let's do its practical by opening MS Word window. Students, you can see that I have already typed a word computer. Now if you want to type another word, you have to give space, but spacebar key will give only single space at a time. And if you want to give multiple spaces at a time, then we will press the tab key from the keyboard. So now we will press tab key and you can see that our cursor jumps to the next location. Now you can type the another word, laptop. Again press the tab key and type the next word, mainframe. This spacing between the present word and the previous word is 0.5 inch by default. So now we will do the second way to set tab stops by using ruler. Simply click on the ruler to insert the tab stop. You can see that I have inserted 3 tab stops at a time. Now type any word from the keyboard. Press tab key and you can see that our cursor has jumped to the next location of the tab stop. Type the second word, laptop. Again press the tab key and again the cursor has jumped to the next location of the tab stop. So this is the way to set tab stop by using ruler. So now we will do the identification of the icons. In the first ID, bullets are given, so it is bullets button. In second ID, we are having 1, 2, 3 numbers, so it is numbering button. Students, you have to note down the shortcut key and ID on your copy also. So today we have discussed about what are bullets and how they enhance the appearance of a document. What are the steps to apply bullets to the text? And what is the meaning of tab stop and default setting of tab stop? Further, we will discuss in next session. Till then, you have to do reading and practice of the page number 39 and 41. Thank you.